So yeah, let's get Haki.
Using my death die.
Okay.
Oh, please.
Jesus.
Don't die.
Okay, dropping the lowest, that puts you at 8. Okay.
Well, so what happens next? He's got complications.
Well, not necessarily.
I have to make a deal with the devil.
Yeah. Well, with death. With Keganis.
With Keganis.
Yeah. Okay.
Who's both angel and devil.
Yeah.
So let's hope you get the good one.
The good one.
I don't know that there is a good one.
So did we establish that gods are still around in Dark Sun?
The gods are...
They left.
Yeah, they left Dark Sun. They abandoned Dark Sun.
It's like Preacher. God's left.
Yeah.
Peter
Shelley.
Yeah. I've read that.
Let me look at your character sheet.
As he just rips it in half.
Yeah.
I love that.
So the
right
bargain.
Now,
the bargain
all of the
is.
The chat is correcting every single thing I just said.
Yeah. Well, yeah. See, that's what the internet is
well,
for.
Well, I also love comedian.
Yeah, I'm not going to lie. I had one of those God, I was born in the 1990s moment because I'm trying really hard to remember the fuck how he was.
Yeah, because these were all like, those. They were big like late 80s.
Yeah.
I don't.
Because I remember watching MTV.
I know American Girl because I was in a couple videos. Movies, but I don't really know a lot about it. Sorry.
Okay.
Television. That's just
death.
Television.
So Keganis, so you awake in a realm of just pure inky void, and you can't even make out the figure in front of you. You just feel his presence in front of you, and the figure says, "Keganis," because Keganis is like, I guess, Pokemon. He says his own name all the time. Anyway, and Keganis says, "It will be better for the city if you save someone. There's a man in the city of Tyr. He owns many slaves. He will be good for the city in the coming days."
Oh, that is a moral question for
Haki. Are you an ex-slave?
Yes. Haki is anti-slavery.
He can help stabilize the city in the coming chaos. But unfortunately, there are many people who wish to see him dead. This is up to you. And you, the same thing happens. You see Haki's eyes open wide and take a breath and spontaneously speak Keganis. And Haki seems perfectly fine.
Drama over, no more sudden... obvious death.
No more sudden obvious death.
Okay, I'm just gonna.
Yeah. I'm gonna
cure light wounds. Hold still. You're fine.
Take that, because I assume that severed arm is still sitting there with that
severed
ring.
Severed arm with the ring is on.
I'm gonna
there.
Take that ring.
Okay. Yeah. You put the ring on.
It's a 4.
Oh, cool.
You put the ring on.
Thanks.
And So you guys see your. See your wizard grab this talon ring off of the severed arm, and the ring is pure black, not obsidian. It looks like it's maybe made of slate or something like that, and puts it on, and immediately you see the remaining foliage in that cart just completely turn to dust, and you all feel a wave of force hit against you.
Oh, dear Lord.
Is he doing the fucking necromancer right now?
I don't know.
And you definitely just defiled.
Yeah,
by
okay.
Putting on that ring.
So it's more than 3. And that definitely is using magic to cause terror and fear, so that's
oh, good. Yeah. Yeah, you can... Because not only did they feel this wave of just unrelenting evil force hit them, everybody else in the Colosseum felt it too, because it just radiates out throughout the city.
Yeah.
So everyone in the city just like looks up at you in fear. And everyone just kind of freezes, because they think, oh shit, like we're back where we were. There's just another sorcerer.
So you're changing your alignment?
No. It's just you get XP when you complete one of these.
When you do a thing.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
So do we eliminate?
I use magic to cause terror and fear.
What's that?
Did we eliminate an unnatural skirt?
Oh,
Yeah, for sure.
Hell yeah.
With this alignment stuff, you get a...
When you fulfill that thing at the end of the session, just like with bonds, except for with bonds, you don't have to check with anybody else. You just say, you know, I think I did this.
And it counts for any one of them. It's not just the one you're...
And it's marking XP. So you can do any of those. Yeah, you don't actually pick so much as it's just like, here's some options.
So I would have gotten for the... I mean, so these... I probably could have gotten one for the last time. Whatever, we can... I'll definitely take one for this one.
So the entire Colosseum is kind of looking at you expectantly, like you're gonna speak or something.
Okay. The Sorcerer King is dead.
Everyone cheers. Everyone cheers. They're still not like completely sold on you. They're like, there's definitely a feeling of like. And
tell them all the slaves are free.
Slavery is no more.
Oh.
The Colosseum goes crazy. Because, like, more than half of the Colosseum, even, like, spectators are, you know, Tyr has this system of, a system similar to what many countries have had, where slavery wasn't slavery in name because people were paid, but all of that money was then taken back for housing, food, whatever.
So rural India.
It was
indentured servitude.
Right. It was indentured servitude, and there was never an opportunity to make that.
Topical.
Oh boy. Everyone knows that this system is in place, but you're not allowed to admit it. So when you say that,
there will be much change.
The vast majority of the people here just start flipping out, like they're just, you've never seen any kind of positive emotions that could match this. Even the party that you guys threw like 4 days earlier, that was nothing. That was just like, oh, our lives suck a little less for one night. But this is like an actual, like this actually feels like things are moving forward. There's no way you can see this and not be at least a little heartened. Even if you believe, well, someone else is going to come in and take advantage, but maybe at least for a little bit, our lives are going to be better.
I'm going to walk over to Steven's body and pick it up. I'm going to carry it down the ziggurat. I'm going to go find a spot in the Colosseum, and I'm going to make sure nobody's really watching me while I'm doing this. Mm-hmm. I'm going to dig a grave. Whatever, I know. I'm going to try and get as much out of the eyes as possible because I'm emotionally affected by this.
Yeah.
I'm going to dig a grave for Steven. And,
kiss him lightly on the cheek?
Aww. Like it's none of your business.
you find... you know, they have like the alcoves where they set up all the gladiators before they come out into the pit, and you go off into one of those alcoves and you're able to dig him a grave safely away from prying eyes. And you can bury Steven's musical instrument with him, or you can keep it.
I think I'll keep the lute.
As a token.
As a token.
Yeah.
The lute.
But you have to write a song for him. It's his dying wish.
I'll write a song for him.
I'd like to go over sweet. To the Sorcerer King's now dead body,
mm-hmm.
remove
its
head, and drink the insides.
You can tell a lot of people are real freaked out by that, but there's a lot of like Thri-Kreen and halflings in the audience that are like super stoked. they love
like,
it.
Like, oh man, I want to try
Thank
some
you.
Of that.
Thank yeah. you. I'm also going to be searching all of the weapons that are down to try to find the best weapon.
You actually do find a metal weapon, which in Dark Sun is crazy unusual. So you see this steel. It's like it's a single bladed axe, but it's made for a half giant. So I mean, technically it's a one handed axe, but like for you it would be two handed because it's just. You're not 14 feet tall, so yeah.
Yet.
Well, yeah.
Okay.
I,
it's good to have goals.
I have no opinion on that. So yeah, and it's clearly made out of steel, and as you pick it up, a sense of, you feel cool.
Like I feel awesome?
You feel temperature cool. You feel
Ooh.
Chilled.
Okay.
And you think,
but like not in a bad way.
No, not in a bad way. And you think actually that this weapon might have some sort of magical powers to it. Like the you see on the edge of the blade, you can almost see a little bit of frost on it.
Which is great.
Do
this
I know
place.
What the damage? I don't know right. until I get to play with
until
it.
Until you hit something with it, maybe.
Okay.
Is there anything psionic on his body and his dead body or anything, or any clothing that maybe isn't armor?
You get a chance to actually kind of look at everything that's around you. There are four what look like reeds. The top of the ziggurat is square, that tall platform that the tower was on. Each of the four corners, the points of that square of the ziggurat, there's what looks like a tall reed, but the reed is made out of bronze or some sort of it's metal that's been pounded to be in the shape of like a tube, and there's four of these. Each as you go up to the ziggurat, now that you're not so preoccupied with combat, you can actually feel psionic energy pulsing from all four of them, and you think that you could enhance. You already have some of the purple water in that water skin,
uh-huh.
and you think between that and these strange reeds, you think that, and maybe a little bit of help from somebody who knows something about rituals, you could probably enhance your already existing psionic abilities with this.
Oh, okay.
If you could convince a magic user to turn this into some sort of a ritual.
On the way back to join the rest of the group, I want to stop by the cart.
Mm-hmm.
Is it possible to grab the copper that's been infused with the stone and add it to my weapon?
The copper does not exist anymore on the obsidian orb. As the orb was like shaking, it was actually burning the copper. Like you could actually see it was like you know, like when you see like a fuse burning, it was like that. It was burning the copper up, absorbing all of this magical energy. But the obsidian orb seems to be in good condition still.
Would I do that ritual now or later?
You can do it now or later.
Yeah.
I can help you with that. We just need something on fire. Oh, look, a body.
Yeah, either way will work. You can do it using...
Can you cast rituals?
Well, no, but he can sacrifice things to the fire, which would be a different type of...
I don't trust your elemental magics for this.
I mean, you know rituals, right?
Yeah.
You give me a hand?
Yeah, I'm Yenin could definitely...
Alright, fine, sure. Do the... Whatever.
You guys got enough of that purple juice for Sizzlak still living around?
I have an extra water skin full of it.
Yeah, if you want to, you can give him yours.
You can try it. It is quite dangerous.
I'm willing to take that danger.
I mean, you could die.
Oh, yeah, you absolutely could die.
I think we all
there
died
was a,
at least
there was a,
once today.
Yeah, there
so.
Was a feedback moment when they drank the water that was real painful.
Who are you? I don't think I have
psionic ability.
Maybe get yourself in a better,
he's
healthier situation first.
All right.
We find him
Farskeen.
So how do I roll for this ritual?
Yeah, well, he'll roll for the... I'm going to just have him do a spellcasting check for the ritual, and then I'm gonna have you, depending on that, roll a Defy Danger. So it might just go fine.
I'm still lighting that body on fire.
I like the way you think.
Let's see, 5, 6, 7, 9?
You don't only have plus one to your...
Oh, yeah, 5.
It's 8.
So, yeah, 10.
Okay, that's a lot better. Yeah, so you
I
don't...
defile. No.
I mean, that's always an option.
Yeah.
And getting to be less of an option, I guess, maybe. So as so the
Demia said it's okay.
So he actually uses he actually, you see him kind of reach his hand towards some of that remaining black goo and uses that as kind of a focus for this ritual, and the black goo dries up and you feel fine. You can also feel the psionic power that you had been given before, your spidey sense.
Mm-hmm.
Actually now gives you +1 ongoing for your Defy Danger.
Cool.
Nice.
My black goo again.
You feel great.
Yeah?
Yeah, you actually feel really good. You feel fine. It does not seem to have any ill effects.
Yeah.
What are you looking at me? I gave you all the information I'm going to give you.
Find yourself, you're starting to really consider voting for the brain slug party this time.
Oh, for sure. Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, they make a lot of sense.
I want to make Dark Sun great again.
Yep, there you go. Yeah, so you actually, in the Colosseum, they've finally gotten the doors unlocked, and they're no longer barred, and the people are just streaming out into the city. And the city is just a complete mess now. You see, obviously, all of the common citizens and, you know, workers and slaves are revolting because they now know that they have the backing of the new Sorcerer King, or whatever this thing, whatever you are.
Yeah.
But they know that it's okay for them to do this now, and they don't need to worry about the Templars, because also the Templar. The Templar Guard of the city have lost all their powers. So none of these Templar are impressive anymore. They're just regular people. And the Templar are, they're just squishy elves and half elves and humans.
Oh, they're gonna die.
Yeah, the Templar have a bad day. we'll say that.
Well,
before we go too far, is there a way to heal anyone?
There's your boy.
Okay.
But that's pretty much, other than resting for a couple of days, that's pretty much it. Dungeon World is kind of lethal.
There's no.
I'll heal you up, because I got to burn a body and kind of stare at it for an hour.
I'll do a commanding shout as well.
What do you want to do? That's not even a 7, is it?
No.
Okay, so you lose the spell.
I'm sorry.
Goodbye, Cure Light Wounds.
You can get it back.
That's okay. I'm going to do it. I'll do a commanding shout then. Some plans. I say we should probably head back to the inn and regroup.
I have to go save a man's life who I hate.
What?
Who I hate?
I got a 7, so I'll get 1, so I can give you a
d4.
A d4 to help.
Right, thanks.
3.
Wait, Haki, what about you going to save someone you hate? What about that now?
I have to go save a man's life. I made a deal, and now I have to make good on it.
All right, well...
I don't know if I'll have time to rest, because given the state of the city and the amount of turmoil that's about to happen, I don't think I have time to go take 2 days, because this man will surely be killed.
Oh, yeah.
If I do not go save him.
You got a potion on you, maybe?
He's a landowner.
I don't. I do not have a potion
on me. I do.
He's a master.
I just realized I do, too.
I've got 4 on me.
Because I used a potion last time.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I've got 3 on me.
I got 1.
Definitely.
You find a potion.
One.
I found a potion?
You found a potion. It heals you for 10 hit points if you want to drink it.
Yeah, drink it. So that
I'm back up to 11.
Can I have a potion?
Yes.
Can I have a potion?
Yeah. We can all have a potion.
Everybody's out of potions now?
Yeah. I mean, that was my stock, but fine.
Well, this is as good a reason as any.
Well, it sounds like Haki has something he needs done, and I'm not one to leave any of our members behind.
Except for that one that today. we left
buried in
the That wasn't me.
I'm
that
sure
was
she's
you
fine.
Guys.
I'm sure she's fine, okay?
I did not leave
and
anyone.
And I feel like I've developed a bond with Haki watching him fight.
Speaking of bonds,
yeah.
This is a good time for Ben to finally fill out his bonds.
Yeah.
All right.
So, I've mentioned this before, but bonds are really fucking cool. In Dungeon World, it's a good way for actors and improvisers to kind of, you know, get a chance to get a little bit of direction for a character. Not that we need it, but I find it fun actually sometimes to have an external source guiding me rather than have it be entirely up to me. And Patreon backers can actually influence the game through bonds. They can also influence the game through fronts, which is basically just essentially designing adventure locations for the game in the future. So, if anybody is interested in that, become a backer of our Patreon, and you will be able to give bonds to the players at our table, and they'll have to... It becomes canon for the character, so they'll have to play the character in a way that recognizes that truth. And I think that's interesting, especially as people who are trained... Everybody here at this table is in some way trained in improvisation, so... everybody here can handle that. Don't fucking look at that. I know you have improv training. I don't care. But anyway, it is. It's training. It's a skill, and people at this table do have that skill. So,
my coach would say you were born a better improviser than you were learned to be.
It's true.
Yeah.
Who's your coach?
Ptolemy Slocum.
Nice.
Oh, Ptolemy.
Yeah, Ptolemy. Ptolemy is great.
Good old Ptolemy.
Yeah. But that being said, much like acting or writing or anything else, it is absolutely a skill, and everybody here has that skill. Please donate or become backers of our Patreon so that you can give more bonds to our players to influence the way they play their characters. Yeah, now that I've done that and vamped for long enough, Ben is going to tell us his bonds.
My bonds? Well, in knowing you for one fight.
James is one of them.
I feel like Sizzlak is always getting into trouble and I must protect them from themselves.
I like it.
It doesn't sound like me, but all right.
And Haki shares my hunger for glory. The earth will tremble at our passing.
Yes.
Yeah.
Nice.
Not bad.
Yeah, I like that. The wrecking crew
is what
I'm
going to call
you.
Do they need to know about the Hakelian appetites?
Oh, yeah. Let's talk about the appetite. I want to know what your appetite is.
So my appetite is for pure destruction.
Oh.
Oh, dear. So read the whole list of options so that people can see what you could have chosen.
Okay, so what I could have chosen are pure destruction, power over others, mortal pleasures, conquest, riches and property, fame and glory. What I have the Herculean appetites for is pure destruction and mortal pleasures. Hence the reason I keep eating all of my kills.
Oh, that's
or other
awesome.
People's kills.
That is awesome.
So great.
Oh, that's so awesome. Okay, so now that I know that, anytime you're planning on eating your foe, instead of rolling the 2d6 like you normally would for your hack and slash, you can roll a d8 and a d6 instead.
Okay.
But you have to. But you have to eat them afterwards.
Yeah.
Okay. That's not always going to be a good idea. I mean, okay, your character's going to disagree with that, so I'm not even going to get into that conversation, but I'm just saying. So you guys find yourself on the outskirts of town towards the mountain range, which backs up against Tyr, and you see a beautiful manor, just a gorgeous house, huge grounds, and clearly,
actually huge or dark side huge?
Actually huge. Oh, because wow. This guy is actually the guy who owns the mines, the iron mines of Tyr. So you see workers streaming out of the mines in the mountains, running towards the manor, and he does have a small mercenary force of guards, which has been now at this point decimated, and he's locked up in his house, but you don't know how long he's going to be able to hold out before these revolutionaries are able to knock down the walls and tear into his house.
Haki, are you sure this is the right place?
This is the right place.
I mean,
this man is not a good man. And I would gladly take his life myself, but this city needs leaders. This man can be a leader for the city.
Hello, my citizens. Your new Sorcerer King speaking.
What?
this man, he has done wrong. But we are a forgiving people, are we not?
Oh boy.
I mean, in any other situation, you'd have to make such a fucking hard charisma check, but they just look at you. Yeah, that's the thing. They just look at you.
I have a ring.
Yeah, yeah. They look. They look at you. They look at you. The slate black ring. Your now necrotized hand, and they just kind of go. Yep.
One while lasting.
And they just full on disperse.
And he eats a sun chip.
Yeah.
Quest finished.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a good point. Yeah. They just disperse. All the miners run off. You know, they kind of steal supplies and mining picks and stuff like that to keep for themselves, to sell in town or what have you. But they're basically just ransacking the working areas and their living quarters and running into town.
This is fine. Children will play.
Oh boy.
I don't think they were children.
Well, a lot of them probably were.
Their tiny hands are good at grabbing metal.
So I guess I will go knock on the wherever he's holed up at, try to pull this guy out of his panic room.
Mm-hmm. Yes, always.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. A little bit. So,
Oh, you mean out of character?
Yeah, no, Ben Dunn.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Also, always.
So always.
Always.
Look at me. It takes a lot.
Yeah, no, I hear you. So, you guys actually now have this. They abandoned this manor. So if you want it, it's yours. You can use it as a base of operations or just a
This is nice house. I take it.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I thought
like watching the rise of something.
Yeah.
I'm
very worried about you have had no concerns about these choices. Yenin, like there's no moral quandary about
I
like,
sent you Yenin's backstory.
I know. I just love it. It's just very much like
so me and Frankie, Frankie's
oh, yeah,
really...
Oh, yeah, Frankie's still here.
Frankie's still
Yeah,
around.
Frank is still here.
Frankie looks at me and says, I might know good places to look around for some things.
And I immediately follow Frankie and go look for, like, some weapons or valuables or something.
There is, unfortunately, the city has already, at this point, been picked pretty clean. However, as Frankie comes back, he says to you, I'm not going to do the voice as
no,
well as you,
it.
But he says, so here's the deal. There's a lot of guys around town. They're asking about the iron. You know, out-of-towners, the merchants and whatnot. There's going to be some problems here, man. Like, who's going to do this now?
People will do it, and people will be paid for the work.
I'm just saying you can make some money.
Mm. Well, if we pull this guy, I say we pull this guy out, we shake him down, we let him live. It's his iron mine. So on the surface, we allow him to continue to run it. But we now own this iron mine. And we just keep him alive to keep order. But we pay people to work the mine. And we sell it.
Absolutely.
And we just we set up shop here in this manor. Yeah.
I am a fan of the way Haki is thinking.
I think it's a good idea.
How do you feel about this? Because my debt is to you, Sizzlak.
Excellent.
This is going to go on.
Damn it.
I'm a fan of this idea. Haki, make it so.
Could there be anything more masturbatory than one person playing two characters at each other in a D&D game?
Yeah. He's like, oh, so I brought these
he could
friends
be
to talk with me. Dad, what are you doing over here?
Hi.
I mean, look.
The ghost of Steve appears.
That's true. Yeah, I'm
Steve.
Yeah, I'm. Yeah, I gotta give you this because you lost. You only. I felt. I was like, oh boy, Steven. Only one session you got out of Steven. Don't worry.
Not even a good session. I mean, like he didn't get to do much of anything.
No, no, he
I
did.
I wanted to hear full songs.
He saved your life.
He did.
Yeah. So yeah, you actually.
I totally would have sacrificed Frankie over Steve in a heartbeat.
I know you would have.
I know.
There's a reason why Steve would.
I know.
Okay. Anyway, so as you're imparting your wisdom to this to the ex owner of these mines, he very quickly is like, "Oh, I understand what you're doing, and I completely agree." He's like, "I will." The owner says, "I concede that you're making good points, and I will. I'm willing to make this compromise with you." So that this can happen.
This is great. The less bloodshed in my new
administration. And you sleep in the old slave quarters.
Yeah, so you're just kind of king now.
I mean, the people demand it.
Hold on. What'd I roll?
Four.
You rolled a four. Right, then no. I was going to try and use words of power on him to help you out. But
he says, I think in the interest of maintaining order, wouldn't it make most sense for me to be in good living quarters so that I will still be seen as the leader?
Yes, he has. I am sure he has. He has lesser rooms. The rooms for the bottom floor is always servants.
Yeah.
Okay. So I have to be in the bottom floor?
No, just you have lesser room.
Okay.
He can
it's
stay.
Not the master bedroom anymore.
Can I have the servants' quarters room then, or the main servant?
Yes.
The head servants' quarters.
Yes.
Okay.
But he get your wife.
Wait.
It's all okay. I'm kidding. I'm a just sorcerer king.
Okay. The old leader of the old head servant actually comes up to you guys and says, it's a dwarf. I appreciate what you guys have done. I really do. It means an awful lot that this is going to be a very different city. Is there any room for us still here, or what is going to happen now?
Absolutely. I'm sure you've heard of Sizzlak the Great the Third.
No, I have not. I've heard of Haki. Are you allied with Haki?
Yes, actually. Haki is one of my...
Oh, he's one of your equals? One of your peers?
Yes.
Wow, you must
fact,
be impressive.
Hold on. Watch this. And I just, like, make a noise. And I'm like, that's Haki, by the way.
Hello. Well met.
He goes down on one knee and like salutes you. You should be our new king. You should be the king of You should be the king of
minor king.
Of all the people.
Listen, there will be talk of who is ruling what, but and I say this while just showing off that but there is there, that is a conversation for another time. Maybe keep such talks in your head and not spoken outside.
I understand. I'm sorry.
What is your beef?
He's gone mad with power.
Yeah, it's
eat
very
Detroit.
Quickly.
A lot of people don't know about this, but there's been some problems in the iron mines for weeks now.
Really?
Unfortunately, we've been producing less and less as time goes by.
Children's hands were getting bigger.
Well, we were losing many people down in the mines. There's some sort of force down in the mines which has been killing our people.
I say we have to get the city under control.
But there's also, there are people for this.
We also have, yeah, we've still got the Veiled Alliance now, like, doing their thing, right?
Right.
What are they up to?
We should meet with the Veiled Alliance. We should come up with a plan of, like, how we transition the city, what we transition it to. Are we turn this into a democracy?
I
was thinking more ruling council with, like, maybe figurehead sorcerer king.
Not you. No.
Why not
no.
me?
I don't like no.
Because
no, I'm with
because
him.
No.
It has nothing to do with what I've seen in the future.
I see.
No,
I see. Fine. The power behind the throne. Yes. Yes. I like this better.
I like the idea of a council which we could all be on, not putting you at the head of the council.
I just said figurehead. Like,
no. Why would we need one?
I mean, obviously, as your leader. I'm a fan of the council idea.
So you guys are able to set up a meeting inside the city with the Veiled Alliance. They now have an open headquarters that
so
you can
not
just
so
visit.
Alliance.
Not so veiled
the,
anymore.
The straight up alliance.
they are now the Naked Alliance.
Ooh.
Yeah, so
that's a misleading title.
Yeah,
it is. Yeah, as you go in.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, as you go in, everyone is very put off by your nakedness. They're like,
no,
we still wear clothes here.
Yeah, I'm a bug, so I
You're always.
Oh yeah,
I'm unclad. In order to get my armor bonus, I have to be unclad.
So you go inside and you see Tact, and Tact says,
"Oh, she's not dead."
Yeah, Tact is totally alive. She says hello to you and gestures for you to sit down at the bar.
Oh man, I missed my. I got a bonus when went to bars with my minstrel.
Aww.
She
find another one.
She motions to the bartender. The half-giant bartender sets down a half a dozen mugs of kank nectar for you.
I drink three of them. Oh, excellent.
The half-giant just keeps bringing them for you.
What's the status in the city? What is it?
Well, we
chaos?
Have
is it?
Yeah, it is very chaotic. As you, there's still looting going on throughout the city.
Sure.
To be expected.
Did you have a plan?
We do, yes, we have a plan.
See, they have.
We have all of the different, cells of the Alliance are organizing their own neighborhoods where they worked before, and we are taking up, like we've done, this building is our headquarters, and we are providing stability in that way.
We've taken over the mine.
Another good step for the Alliance.
And we're letting the foreman live.
Well, probably not necessary, though.
No, but...
Trust us, that
He is experienced in running mine, and he knows who his masters are.
Ooh, that is an uncomfortable sentence.
It's very uncomfortable.
The words, they don't always...
No, I know. I remember.
We've just abolished slavery.
Yes.
It's going to take them at least a week to get out of the lexicon.
Okay, now, we need... The people need some sort of stability, so we are planning on having some sort of city by... or neighborhood by neighborhood representation. So each area of the city will have a Veiled Alliance member representing that section of the city.
Do they get the Jews, or are they just going to be...
Oh, it'll. I'm the leader of my cell, so I would represent this area. The leader of that cell will represent that area. We already have a built-in hierarchy for the cells. We just need to tie all the cells together now. Many of us don't know each other because we were supposed to work independently, but now that we're able to, we can tie all of the different cells together.
And how does one go about doing that?
We're in the process of organizing now. I've been in contact with several other cells, and I'm sure it should go pretty smoothly. Everybody should be able to get on board with the idea that we'll all work together, and then we'll have to figure out what that means. How one cell is more important than another cell. I'm not sure how that works.
I propose that we, while you work out how your cell will begin to run the city, that we'll take the iron mine and we'll get it back up and running. There seems to be some issues deep down within that we'll take care of. In the meantime, I think I would suggest that we make the iron mine a much like the old legends of Hugo Chavez. We take the iron mine and we make it a citywide business, meaning while we will profit off of it, of course, for running it, that the sale of the iron will be taxed and directly sent to the coffer of the city to help boost the economy.
Interesting.
And give jobs to the people here.
The Sorcerer King was never able to do that before because it was always a way to keep the merchant class happy because they profited so much off the iron mines. So it'll be interesting to see how the merchant class responds, knowing that now they won't be able to make that money anymore.
Well,
you know, almost three-quarters of commerce in Tyr is directly related to the iron mines.
Well, the iron mine belongs to the earth. How could the merchants claim any ownership off of it?
Oh, right. I think it's quite simple. You just say, hey, I own this.
Well, they don't own it any longer.
I think it also helped. We free slaves. Slaves get job, make money, buy things. Merchant have more money because slaves now buy things.
Exactly.
So they'll need to... Interesting. Well, I mean, to be honest, I'm thinking out loud. I don't particularly care. The merchants could all be strung up for all I care, and it really wouldn't have an impact on me one way or another. So...
Do any of them have nicer houses?
Funny joke.
Oh, no, I'm just saying, practically speaking.
Yeah, it's funny.
Okay. Okay, Haki. I want to thank you so much. And if you have any advice to give me going forward, although I'm sure what we have worked out with our system of cells is going to work out fine, we always were able to band to, you know... Whenever you have a goal to work towards, people band together. I don't think there will be any problems getting the city unified and solving these issues going forward. I think we'll all be able to agree moving forward. And if not, I'm sure you'll be able to help us.
All this talk of politics bores me.
I understand.
I don't understand anything of what you guys are talking about.
Well, might I offer then... The iron mines?
Yes.
You mentioned clearing it out. Please feel free to deal with that. I don't mean to bore you with politics.
No, I think we should. I think we should go.
Absolutely.
Take a night's rest. A couple nights rest. And then head down into the iron mines.
I just realized all
Maybe
of us are
some
bullied.
Potions?
We're just covered.
We are messed up.
We are fucked.
Yeah, you have all gotten... wrecked in one way or another. I think everybody...
I feel like we look good.
Actually, you...
I feel great.
You're in the best shape out of everybody, I think. And
I'm at max.
Yeah.
Well, but I mean, like, as far as the sheer beating that you all took, I think you took the least beating out of everybody. I mean,
you were chasing a Templar the whole time.
Squishy elf. He was eating a Templar the whole time, to be clear.
Most of the blood I have on me is from draining heads.
Mm-hmm. Eating
I took
and drinking
the most
flesh.
Emotional wreckage.
So you guys go back to your. You guys go back to your. Yeah.
You gonna be okay over there?
I'm fine.
Thri-Kreen are notoriously sociopathic. Actually, they are real bad at reading social graces. So, anyway, so you go back to your new manor by the iron mines, and there are fluffy beds everywhere. Like you have never seen, you've never laid down in a bed like this before. It's absolutely amazing. In fact, this might be the first time any of you, maybe Yenin, has slept on a real mattress before. And it is real nice.
This is fantastic.
I turn mine apart and make a nest.
Yep.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Steve.
I'm a bed bug.
Yeah, you guys, oh boy. You know what? Yes.
I'm a bed bug.
Yes.
Take inspiration with that one.
Yeah.
I'm going to say 12 hours into gaming, I finally get one.
Yeah, it is. By the way, let's just really look at that. You have been here since...
I haven't been here since the beginning.
Right, but since what, like midnight or 11? Right?
2.
2? 2 a.m. 3 a.m.?
I started at the 3 a.m. game.
Oh, boy.
Jesus.
That's a lot.
Yeah. So almost 12 hours.
Oh, you've been here forever.
No. Let's be fair. Dom and Sax have been here the entire time.
Yeah.
Some heroes back there.
Well, you know, guys, that's really what it's all about.
It's about Dom.
You know,
it's all about Dom.
It's
Sax.
It's
all about the Dom.
It is, and I quote.
It's Sax.
It's all about the Dom.
And
Sax. And I don't want this to come off twee or even earnest, you know. And those are two things that I'm not one to be twee or earnest, but I want to say this.
No.
It's important. Guys, it's real important. We're doing the Lord's work here.
Yeah.
And to ever disrespect the work that's being done on the other side of the camera, to me... It makes me angry, but it makes me sad.
And just for the viewers that can't see, Dom isn't his real name. He's just always drinking Dom Perignon.
Yeah.
So mm-hmm. that's his nickname.
Well, but that's
literally just pouring.
Wearing a leather hood.
Bottle after bottle.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Dom is our champagne guy, and yeah. Sax is our jazz guy. And you know,
Sax is always wearing a saxophone.
Yeah,
yeah,
Sax.
Inventive when it comes to nicknames.
Oh, yeah,
no,
we're not
good at it.
No.
Very,
we
basically look at people
just
and go,
you,
oh, you've got this thing,
Sax.
So you're this.
Yeah. Well,
I mean, let's be fair, it's weird.
Well,
oh, it is. They're both super weird.
Yeah.
Like, they're not normal quirks.
No, they're not normal quirks, and they're not endearing.
No, no. Because Dom also has a monocle, and he doesn't share any of the champagne with anybody.
I saw
him. Sounds like gross.
Yeah.
That's true. Yeah. Well, and I saw on the way in, I thought Sax was being nice letting me into the building, but he was actually going out to hit a homeless person with his saxophone.
Yeah.
I was like, huh. Not
then,
a choice I would have made.
He, but the reason he did that was because the homeless man had a sack.
Yeah.
And he's been collecting more of those lately.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah, just a necklace.
He's transitioning from sax to sax.
Yeah. Oh, and you know, I think
also he didn't even ruin your birthday. He just played Careless Whisper over and over again,
but not the
all
full
night long.
Not the full song.
Yeah.
Just that intro.
Just that saxophone.
It was. It was about 9 seconds on loop.
Yeah.
Oof.
And it was a 4-hour birthday. So
and it wasn't a tenor sax like it was written for. It was an alto sax.
Oh.
Yeah.
He was yawning it up.
Oh Jesus.
I brought a soprano to offer.
Thanks. Thanks for an extended riff on our producers. That was real fun.
By the way, that was brought to you by Beard Oil.
Oh, nice.
Hey. One of our sponsors.
Is it really?
Generic, non-branded beard oil.
We're trying to get beard oil to be our sponsor.
Yeah.
This could be your beard oil that we're holding.
Well, and you had to shave.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. Yeah,
sorry.
Max had the most epic beard.
I'll grow it back.
Okay, so.
Do you have a beard?
No.
No,
I've never shaved.
I was just going to say, it does not look like, it doesn't look like you could grow a beard.
I could not.
That's fine.
Have you ever let it grow out before?
No, because it looks, it's like, you know when you were in like middle school and like the first kid that got like 6 hairs and he thought like, oh God, Terry's got a mustache. That's what me at 30
what's
is.
What's happening here?
No, significantly less.
Yeah. It looks,
I mean
that's...
all of these beards like puts this, like every
Here's
single beard,
it
there's
took,
a lot of beards
this
in this
took
room.
A lot of, like, I,
there are
for
a lot
long
of beards
time,
in this room.
I did not think I could do this.
There's a real, but part of that is LA is real beard heavy.
We're
right
real
now.
Beardy.
Yeah.
Can we bring all the beards up front for just a second?
I don't,
all the
no,
beards in the room?
No, you are not going to expose that. No.
There's so many.
There are 4 beards
just,
off camera right now.
Yeah, there are.
Every single person in this room off camera has a beard.
Yeah.
No,
4-5
yeah.
of the room has
you guys,
a beard.
It's not true.
Amy Vorpal is back there sporting a beard right now.
Yeah.
Well, she
is
a beard.
What's crazy is,
that's why I said stop it.
Oh.
It's also crazy
stop
how
it.
Quickly she can grow a beard.
Yeah.
It's just like that.
No, it's actually, it's one of those, like, they do that in movies. They cover it with, like, it's a prosthetic, flesh-colored prosthetic she puts over her beard when she's on strong.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that's why her face is so lumpy on
She walks up.
Okay, so you guys find yourself in the Iron Mines.
Yeah. Right. That's
full health, full health.
You're at full health after sleeping in the fluffy beds.
I'll level next time.
Next thing.
Yeah, yeah. You can. We'll level at the
Would
end
I have
of the
had time to go to Demia and find the thing that I asked him vaguely for? Or is it
Yeah. He gives you a scroll.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can we resolve bonds super quick? Or no,
we'll
we should do that later off camera.
You know what? Let's go through leveling. Yeah. I think that'll be good because we haven't done that on camera yet, and if people are interested in how Dungeon World works, then this is one way we can do it. So,
I know what kind of scroll it is?
It's a scroll of teleportation.
So, who's going to start? Yes.
So who wants to start? Here has enough XP to level? Everybody?
I don't know. I'd like to go through this really quick because I have my alignments, my lawful says bring balance to a chaotic situation, which I feel like
you absolutely did that.
And then defend the weak from the unenlightened. I feel like by freeing slaves.
We're gonna do one alignment per session.
Oh, okay, cool.
That's what I was gonna say, 'cause I had like 3 on that as well.
Yeah, I was gonna say, 'cause I did all of these.
Yeah. So pick an alignment.
Okay.
Get mark XP if you did one of those.
Okay.
Yours, I'm sure you did. Yours, I know you did. Yours, I know you did.
What was yours? I eliminated a natural scourge.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Sorcerer kings are unnatural scourges.
Mine was chaotic and IFs. absolutely eschewed the conventions of the civilized world.
Oh,
by decapitating people into and eating their
drinking, eating
with
blood
an
flesh.
Audience, no less.
Yeah, yeah.
In front of the entire city.
Sure. Yeah, that
minus
sounds real good to me.
Yeah, yeah.
So everybody marks one XP for that. Now, mark an XP if you overcame an obstacle. Not the Sorcerer King, because that would be defeating a foe.
What about
so
death?
Mark XP for defeating the Sorcerer King, everybody.
Wow.
Okay, you know what? Mark 2 XP for defeating the Sorcerer King. You're supposed to only get one, but that was really fucking hardcore.
Yeah.
Courtesy of James and Keeganis and
yeah.
Castles and Chemo and,
mm-hmm.
and all that. Okay, overcome an obstacle. Yeah, those of you who had to roll last breath, I think you're... I think you earned that one XP.
Even if I didn't roll, I think I would get it for having
yeah.
saved that
oh.
that guy who I hate.
Yeah. No, that was a real tough situation. Okay, now from there, does anybody want to try and resolve a bond?
Yeah, I think I'd like to resolve my Sizzlak bond.
Yeah.
Okay. So and what bond is that?
It's sad to think, but Sizzlak's not the sort of person to sacrifice themselves for others.
Okay. And you feel that that either no longer informs how you need to play the character, or you feel that a storyline relating to that has resolved itself.
I feel like it was. I think that he, as a character, made a choice to do something he normally wouldn't have done, or
yeah.
he had never done before.
Yeah.
So I feel like this used to apply to him, but now he's. You know,
it just doesn't. It doesn't.
Just doesn't
anymore.
Apply to.
And you would agree with that?
I agree with that.
Okay,
yeah.
great.
So
you
each
can.
Get experience?
No, only it's just him because
right.
he's the one who resolved the bond.
Yeah.
So that's pretty much how you resolve bonds, Ben. Is it's just basically whoever you have the bond with, they have to say, yeah, I agree that we can.
And
kind
what
of
is
move
the
past
what's
this
the level
one.
Again?
It's 7 plus your level.
Yeah.
Right.
So if you're level 1, to go to level 2, you need 8 XP. If you're level 2, then you need 9.
Okay. Sweet. Well, I think I've got two. I've got at least one bond. I think.
Okay. What do you want to try and resolve?
Yenin was led by me in the past to failure. Do you want to resolve? Because I led you to non-failure.
Yeah.
I believe that's called success.
And
sure.
I've been trying to teach him to be a leader, and I feel
yeah,
like
yeah, that came up a lot.
Yeah, he's definitely a leader now.
Okay.
Now, so do we put another name in that bond, or is that bond gone?
That bond is gone forever.
Oh, okay.
You will get a new bond, and this is something that I was mentioning earlier with our regarding our Patreon backers. We will be in the process of communicating with our Patreon backers. Yeah, you get one XP for resolving a bond. So, Patreon backers, you guys are going to have the opportunity to... give a bond to these players for next week. We're not going to do that right now. That'll happen offline over the course of the next week or so. But you guys will all get bonds from Patreon backers. And if you guys are not Patreon backers, then be one so that you can give bonds to these people, because it's going to have a huge impact on how we play these characters. I mean, the perfect example, that one little bond of Haki, you know, saying that Sizzlak was not a self-sacrificing person, that led to, I think, a really cool moment in today's game. Like, it was really cool. And those are the type of things that come up when you play, and the Patreon backers can have a huge impact on that. Like, you know, it's cool that you also give us advantage. We really appreciate those donations. But the Patreon stuff, I think, is going to be, in the long run, much more impactful in the story that we tell. And I hope that our Patreon backers want to help us tell a story. That's what I think is really cool about Dungeon World. So, anyway, do you have a bond you want to
resolve?
Yes,
I do. I'm inspired by Sizzlak's bravery. I feel like the story's complete. Like, you proved yourself and everything. So, do you agree?
Yeah, I'll agree
cool.
with that.
Cool.
All right. Do you have a bond you want to resolve?
No, I mean, we had one. There was one.
I think if we go down this mine, we'll
yeah,
crack some
I think
skulls
there's still
together.
More.
There's
I think
more
that the thing that the reason I created the bond was the 1-2 punch at the very first Templar.
Yeah.
yeah.
But,
I just
want yeah, to
drop
no.
some toothpicks and see if we
okay, can so did we loot something of great value this week?
I did.
Okay, so everybody mark.
Too, yeah.
Wait, we took a mansion.
Yeah, so you definitely took a head.
Well, I was also talking about the. Obviously magical.
Oh, yeah, the obviously magical. I was thinking of you yeah. taking heads.
Eh, that's a day in the life of...
That's true. That's not
skin.
Great value.
Sweet.
That's
up,
every day for
Foreskin.
You definitely got the ring. Yeah, I think, I mean, the manor, I think, counts for everybody else, or the mines, or, you know, yada, yada, yada.
I have an actual loot.
Yeah, he did.
Oh,
get
that's
a
right.
It does mean a lot to you.
Yeah, that that's it is really of great value. So okay, so everybody marks one XP for that.
But we don't do it for the mansion if we marked one.
No, you only mark okay, one for any time. Just as long as you've got something of value. So now, does anybody who here has enough to level?
I do.
Okay, so you're going to be level two now, or you're
level
gonna,
three,
and you're going to be level three.
Three.
Three. Three, but you're going to remain level two?
Yeah.
And you're going to remain level two.
And I don't get any sort of XP for using an
advanced No, that's just like a feat that you get. So how much XP are you at now? Five?
Five.
What are you at, Haki?
I'm at eight.
Okay. So you need one more. You need four more. Yeah. And you all leveled. So you're down
Am
to
I
probably
level two?
One or two. Yeah, you're already
I'm
at
down to
two.
Five.
Oh, okay.
And that's zero. That is what you got.
Five. Yeah, I was at four. Because
I didn't want to start you at
oh my
level
God.
One.
I see.
Yeah,
how many fails did you have?
Last week, a lot.
Yeah, so and that's a big cool thing about Dungeon World is the sting of failure is not quite as bad because you get to mark XP every time you roll a six or lower. So that's pretty neat. When you leveled last week, what did you decide to pick?
I took Cauterized Wounds, so Cure Light Wounds was a root, and how do you pronounce that word?
Rote.
Rote instead of a spell.
So it's essentially it's a cantrip, mm-hmm. which is kind of cool. What did you do?
Last week I took I got the spell Mirror Image, and I made Magic Missile basically a cantrip for me.
Sweet.
I did Loyal Followers last week.
So you leveled up last
loyal.
so you leveled up last week, and
or
you ended
two weeks
up,
ago, yeah.
or 2 weeks
yeah.
ago yeah right because you were failing so much you leveled before everyone
yeah mm-hmm. I was I've had an entire game that I wasn't involved in and I'm
and
the
you're
same
still
level with these
yeah, yeah,
guys.
Yeah 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 rolling those failures good job
yeah.
So yeah the interesting thing about that is you got to level four everybody else you picked your new thing you got two followers which was pretty sweet.
Mm-hmm.
And then before you even spent one session with those followers that you got from leveling, you lost one of them.
Yeah.
We'll have to figure that out.
That's sad.
We'll have to figure that out.
Yeah.
What did you pick when you leveled?
I picked Expanded Mind, which just gave me one extra focus. So
okay.
My focus maximum is four.
All right. So. I have Flame Strike now.
Oh, and is your skull thing, was that what that your thing
smash
was?
Is.
Yeah, smash.
Okay. Yeah, so whenever he rolls a 12...
Yeah, I didn't realize, that's why I was like, what is that move that you got for no reason?
Yeah, yeah, whenever he rolls a 12 or higher on hack and slash, he can just take a thing, or somebody loses a thing, whether that is, you know, an arm, a head, or it could be a weapon, or it could be... I mean, it could be
you can't just
anything
always take a head, right?
No. In that situation, I was more than happy to let
yeah.
him take the head.
I mean, he was only a few hit points
that's
away.
Yeah.
You were so close to killing him anyway. I was like, well,
oh
it needs
God.
To be something cool like a decapitation. All right, so...
Dude, I know what I'm going to take next time, though.
I'm going to quit vamping for time, and I'm going to wrap us up a little early, and we can play a game in the interim for the next 30 minutes. I'm sure we've got some sort of indie game we can play, right, Dom?
Yeah, sure.
Cool.
Oh, I thought our
it's
time...
It's called D&D. Have you played
nice.
It?
Nice.
Yeah.
That's not catching on, is it?
No, it's really not. Yeah, I've heard the recent edition is not selling very well. Real unpopular. Not very many people are coming back to D&D.
Listen, they strayed away from 4th edition.
And that's really where they made a mistake.
I don't like 4th
edition. I did too.
I was really
I'm
like,
fine
yeah.
just
you
jumping on board.
It was my first one.
4th edition was awesome.
4th edition is like...
World of Warcraft.
Overcomplicated.
It is very complex.
These monsters started me playing RPGs just on 2E.
All,
right.
all that being said, I'm gonna. So Steven, where should people follow you on social media?
Follow me on Twitter at StevenJPope22.
Do you have anything you want to plug?
Not right now. No.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, you can follow me on Twitter. I'm at Duncor, D-U-N-C-O-R. Or you can check out my podcast at JustCoolEnough.com.
I am Justin. You can find me on most social medias under Acts for Food, A-C-T-S, the number four, the word food. That's Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. You can
which
also,
is all you need to pay him, by the way.
Yeah, that's it. And then you can also check out my photography, because I'm also a photographer, at photo-baker on Facebook or .com. And then I'm also in an improv group you can come check out if you're a big Harry Potter fan and you live in the area. Or if you're going to be in Vegas, I think we're going to be going to Leviosa.
Oh, nice.
Which is a Harry Potter con. We're going to be up there.
It's Leviosa. Yeah.
Leviosa.
Leviosa.
I really do. I'm so upset.
We're called this. We're called the show that shall not be named. And you can find us on Facebook as well.
Wow. Did he eat up my
Actually, can I?
Can I? I've got more than you.
I would like to, I just want to retroactively take time from both of them so that we can somehow have enough for you.
Yeah, don't check out my podcast.
No. My name is Max Crandall.
You don't need to know my Twitter.
Okay, good.
Find me on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram at Who Wants Crandy.
Every time.
I love hearing it. Crandy, C-R-A-N-D-Y. And I don't know, watch BoJack Horseman.
Yeah, BoJack is fucking sweet.
Is that your Snapchat too?
I don't know what my Snapchat is. I'm on Snapchat, Max Crandall, find me.
Right. I'm only on Instagram, I don't really tweet. Yeah. That's a thing of the past, guys. Twitter, Instagram, and I think Snapchat as well is at Dungeon. It's on the screen. And then, you know, to plug something, I work for a little company called Loot Crate.
Spell it right.
Yeah.
Oh.
I spelled it wrong.
D-U-N-N-J-A-M-I-N, not Dunjamain.
Maybe it should be Dunjamain.
Dunjamain.
Somebody grab that up because it's going to be totally worth a lot of money.
Sounds very
Japanese.
But I
do,
snatch it up.
If you guys are fans of the show Firefly, I am. I work with Loot Crate making the Firefly crate that is currently on sale.
Yeah. Nice.
So please, it's this month's theme is Jane, everyone's favorite scoundrel.
The scoundrel.
Yep.
The town of Jane.
And it's awesome. So if you're a fan of Firefly, please get this crate. It's in your best interest.
Yeah. That is a good episode.
Oh,
man.
So good. It's like, I don't know. If that's what happened to that money. God darn.
You know, it's
great.
Funny. How
the guy.
Thank you so much for tuning in, guys. Stick around. We've got some D&D fun coming up, which is going to be really neat. Please
38 hours.
Yeah, yeah. Only 30 hours ago. Please back us on Patreon. You can follow me at Mrs. Hongraham on Twitter. I may or may not. We'll see how that works out. And anyway, but more importantly, follow Saving Throw on Twitter. Follow Saving Throw on Facebook, and get on the Patreon, please, please, please. It's that is going to make it so much easier for us to do even more. We have expanded so much over the past couple of months, and the better our Patreon does, the more we're going to be able to do shit like this and even cooler shit. So please, please, please take care of that.
I'm looking around. These table of white men are going to leave, so an almost identical table of white men can come sit down.
Folks, thank you for tuning in to another episode of Saving Throw Live. This is going to be our first episode of an actual campaign. No more one-shots.
Thank God.